Recently, I put out a video about snapjaw ants who move their mandibles faster than any other ant on Earth or any other animal. And someone in the comments wrote, could this sever my finger? The answer to that question is no. Here's actually what a snapjaw ant versus a finger would look like. But I appreciate the question. I get asked that a lot in response to these ants. These are one of my primary study organisms, these trapjaw ants of the genus Odonomachus. They also have spring-loaded jaws, and when they're released, they snap shut at speeds averaging 41 meters per second, or about 90 miles an hour. And it does seem like something moving at 90 miles an hour, even if it's an ant, would hurt if it hits you. So to capture what a mandible snap against a finger would look like, I've got this set up here in the ant room. This is a high-speed camera, and it's got a macro lens attached to it, so we're going to film this up close and in super slow motion. The camera is going to capture at 3,200 frames per second, and it's all going to happen here on this tiny little platform. So we're going to put the ant on the platform so her movement is restricted, and then I'll just set my finger at the end, and hopefully she'll find it and snap, and everything will be in focus, and it'll work out. So you can see the mandible strike doesn't do anything to my fingertip. I can feel it, but just barely. But a snap does generate enough force to send the ant flying back away from my finger. Here are the two frames in the shot where the jaws go from open to close. What you're seeing is 312 microseconds, or less than 1/3000th of a second. To actually capture mandible movement, snaps have to be filmed at a frame rate of at least 60,000 frames per second. Because the mandibles are accelerating at over 1.5 million meters per second squared, which is roughly how fast a bullet would accelerate in the barrel of a gun. However, force is a product of mass and acceleration. And in this case, the mass of the things that are accelerating the mandibles is super, super small. Trapjaw mandibles are hollow, and the weight of a single mandible is 0.07 milligrams, which is about the weight of a single grain of salt. So in this case, even though the mandibles are being swung really quickly, their tiny mass limits how much force they can actually generate. While on a human scale, the forces might not be that great, on an ant scale, mandible strikes are explosive. The estimated force from the strike of just one of the two moving mandibles is 400 times greater than the ant's own body weight, or about 3.08 grams of force. Trapjaws like these actually use strikes against objects or their environment as an escape mechanism, launching themselves several body lengths away from danger. So against a tough skin thing like a fingertip, mandible strikes are deflected, but against smaller, soft-bodied insects, these strikes can be deadly. For instance, here's footage I captured at 225,000 frames per second of a mandible strike landing on the abdomen of a termite. Okay, so that's what a mandible strike against a finger looks like. It doesn't hurt. I should mention that these ants do have a pretty powerful sting, which does hurt, so they're not completely harmless to us. And I guess the other take-home message from this video is if you ask a question in the comments, I might just spend a month thinking about it and then make a video in response to it. So if you have questions about this or any other thing about these ants in here, leave them in the comments and we'll see what happens.